Okay, thank you, Martin, for the invitation to speak on behalf of Spire and to give a presentation on a new concept, what we call the Hubs for Circularity. And I would like to present it as a way to make local regional initiatives climate neutral and circular in a more competitive way. As already mentioned by François-Nicole just before, this plans of the future will become more and more integrated, cross-sectorial, etc. And I think strongly show this by showing you on the bottom of this introductory slide the different sectors that are involved in Spire, which is the refining sector, the pulp and paper sector, the minerals, the non-ferrous metals, cement, water, steel, ceramics, chemicals, and engineering. I replace today Angels Orduña, who is the director of Aspire, and I am the vice chair of the advisory board of the new public-private partnership process for Planet to the EC. I am also senior advisor for sustainable chemistry at RTO Vito in Belgium. I'm the chair of the advisory board of BioHorizon, which is shared consortium to produce bio-based aromatics, and I'm also professor at the Antwerp University. So in order to explain you the hubs of circularity, I think it's extremely important to show you better what our consortium is doing and what is the place of these hubs for circularity. So this public-private partnership process for Planet is a vibrant community. We've joined strategic vision. As I mentioned, we have 10 sectors. We are working in more than 20 countries, and we have about 160 members up to now. This is still growing. We try to develop and deploy climate neutral solutions to close the energy and the feedstock loops, to achieve global leadership of the process industry, and also, and it's maybe the most important, to accelerate innovation and unlock public-private investments. But of course, we are dealing with a few big challenges. Here I give you an overview of the CO2 emissions by our sectors. So the graph is not complete because refining and pulp and paper sectors still need to be added. But our challenge is to reduce 700 million tons CO2 emissions on an annual basis. You can see part of it is linked to the electricity that we consume. Part is a result of the process emissions, which is quite tricky, and a huge amount is due to the fossil fuel combustion for the electricity needs, but especially for the heat needs and for our process needs, etc. This is the challenge at the level of the emissions. If we look to the challenge at the wastes, then we see that you see an overview of the waste that is generated in Europe. At around 1,500 million tons are more or less linked to the process industries that I just mentioned. And so it's a big challenge to reduce that waste, but especially to make it more circular. So what is the way we look at it? So we look to this climate neutrality ambition. And here we try to go from the energy that we need for our processes to what we call renewable energy. So we do that by, on one hand, looking to the replacement of fossil-based energy by alternative fuels like green hydrogen, by using other fuels than fossil for producing the thermal energy. We do that by electrifying our processes, but also by capturing and using the CO and the CO2 that is released by our processes, so the typical process emissions. And of course, energy efficiency and heat reuse are extremely important in the overall approach. The same story counts for the circular resources ambition. There you see on the left-hand side the role of the process industry. So we take primary resources and we transform them into materials, and these materials are transformed by the manufacturing industry into products and then consumed and then ends up as waste. And our role is not only to treat or reuse the wastes from our process industry, but also to look to the wastes that are produced during the manufacturing and the end of life waste, so after use by the consumers, to bring it back as secondary resources for our processes. So it is much more than just recycling. It is really transforming the wastes into secondary resources that are as good as the primary resources. And so the idea is to reduce as much as possible the input of primary resources and to make the whole system circular. And this brings me more and more to these hubs for circularity. You can see that process industry alone cannot work because a lot of waste is generated later on in the system. So it's really the different places in the value chain where we are looking to make the flows completely circular. Also, I might not forget to say that this is not only at the level of the waste, but also at the level of the wastewater. And finally, this is not possible if we don't do it with a competitiveness ambition. So nobody will want to pay extreme amounts of money for it. So we really have to unlock the private investments and the barriers to the market in order to come to a climate neutral and circular solution. We will do that by creating jobs, for forcing to a circular economy, making more sustainable processes, but also much more sustainable materials, introducing circular regions. This brings me again to these hubs of circularity. And finally, we will want to make a climate neutral continent. And so we will drive this innovation portfolio towards first of a kind plants. So that's really our ambition, and I would like to explain that in this slide. In the left hand side, you see the technology developments at TRL 4, 5, and then we go to system prototypes at TRL 6 to 7, and then we go to demonstrators at TRL 8, and this is more or less all covered by Horizon Europe. But our 10 industrial sectors have decided to go to the first of a kind factories in this new developed system. So this is really TRL 9, in order to show everywhere in Europe the integration of the different aspects in order to come to a climate neutral and circular economy. And by the way, we call that marbles because we find that these first of a kind factories will really be quite bright, nice issues that will make that a lot of other companies in Europe and later on also in the world will follow. So we are very proud. We have at the moment about a list of 50 to 70 of these first-of-a-kind production sites or marbles that we would like to roll out if our program will work and will be feasible technically and economically. I must also say that it is fully in line with the different KPIs of the new Green Deal pact of the European Commission. So it's in line with the climate KPIs. It's in line with the circularity KPIs, and of course, as I mentioned already, competitiveness for us is an extremely important issue. And there we believe that only this full approach, this integrated approach, can support this competitiveness. Just as a repetition, maybe, but we look to the impact on climate. We look to the fact that at the moment most of the business models are linear and not circular. And we have, of course, a third problem, which is based on competitiveness. We translated this in very specific objectives, which led to 12 innovation areas. And this is what we are working on. And here you see a list of these innovation areas. We have renewable energy integration, heat reuse, electrification, electrically driven processes, the use of hydrogen, CO2, as well as capture, utilization in minerals and in chemicals and polymers, energy and resource efficiency, circularity of materials, digitalization, and non-technological aspects. And in order to get there, we believe that industrial urban symbiosis and these hubs for circularity are extremely important to reach our final goals. And here you see an overview of the different elements that will contribute to the final 100% or 90% CO2 emissions that is our ambition. And you see that one of the elements is also linked to the symbiosis between industry. So every element in what I just mentioned to you in the innovation areas, etc., play its role, one more than the other one, and it depends on the technology, it depends on the sector, etc. But every element will play its role to come to a final of 100% reduction. And there, industrial symbiosis can help us a lot as well to contribute to it, but also to make it more competitive. And in that way, we defined the concept for hubs for circularity, which are self-sustaining economic industrial ecosystems for full-scale industrial urban symbiosis and circular economy, closing energy, resources, and data loops. And in resources, I would like to mention that's also water. And bringing together all relevant stakeholders, technologies, infrastructures, tools and instruments necessary for the incubation, implementation, evolution, and management. So this is based on territorial systemic solutions. So it's a regional approach. So we make use of the geographic proximity, and we try to make the process for planet process industry really inside and in the heart of the system. And the facilitation of setting up these hubs is necessary to overcome non-technological barriers to this symbiosis. So we work with a regional community based on industries, startups, research and academia, but also extremely important, the public sector, so the authorities, the local authorities, and the local society. And we do that by developing sustainable business models that make use of this geographical advantage, but also create new value chains, make use of co-investments, which is extremely important in this competitiveness issue, and come in that way to economic solutions. And of course, we try to go to really disruptive innovations based on recycling, alternative resources, material design, and of course, digitalization, but also logistics, which play a huge role, especially in this geographical proximity advantage. We defined starting hubs, intermediate hubs, advanced hubs, and nature hubs. So it's a whole possibility to join in somewhere and then to move on to full major hubs for the future. We have already a portfolio of a lot of projects in that field based on technologies, but also on IT platforms and tools. LCA, we have a lot of success already, and we also defined several barriers. And at the moment, several calls for proposals are also going on in that field. We have the calls Inspire One, but also the Green Deal calls. And now in the future, also in Horizon Europe, some new calls will pop up. I cannot stress enough that the process industries really must play the role to reintroduce bulk amounts of resources into the industrial processes, avoiding waste going to landfill. But I would also like to say that I would like to say avoiding waste just go to a kind of downcycling. So the idea is really that a material that is at the end of its life or that is as a waste somewhere in the value chain can go back to a full secondary resource without any compromise at the level of quality. So further, we work on the objectives alignment of the European regions and SPIRE, and we combine there that with our vision, which is zero waste, climate neutrality, and competitiveness. And we will make use of the high potential to these synergies by connecting the local stakeholders, being process industries, but also other sectors, including manufacturing, etc., the public sector and the civil society, with the regions, but also across the regions. And across the regions, there I would like to introduce what we call the European Community of Practice, which is a platform for non-competitive exchange of knowledge and best practices. So combining, as you can see, all the hubs for circularity in Europe and providing these hubs a practical toolbox on technologies and tools, innovation programs for finding the missing pieces in the puzzle of the symbiosis, modeling circular concepts for the plants of the future, enhancing, of course, from one example to the other, the replicability, also support to communication and policy outreach, and also, it was also mentioned by François this morning, education and training are playing an enormous role, and we will wake or supervise the sustainability of the network as well. In that way, I would like to announce that on 6 and 7 October, we organize a workshop to discuss the hubs of circularity. And we will have also a brokerage on EU Horizon Europe topics with industries and experts. And we will also organize a site event in October in the framework of the 18th European Week of the Regions and the Cities. And further information will follow, and you can always contact me on that. In order to close my lecture, I would like to show you that Process for Planet, so these process industries, are part of the full circle of the value chain. We depend on resources that we have to take in to make the first materials that are then used by the manufacturing industry and then going to society. And then at the end of the use by the society, waste management in regions and cities must bring it back to primary resources in order to close the circle. And the big challenge and the big goal is to minimize the input of primary resources. We know that Europe depends a lot on input of primary resources from elsewhere, so closing the circle is extremely important. And this is not just done by the process industry, but we need the different sectors, the different stakeholders, including the society. With that, I would like to close this lecture by saying that we connect the hubs for circularity across borders, and we focus as much as possible on these circular flows in such a hub. I cannot repeat it enough, a circular flow is the exchange of heat, the exchange of energy, of water, of materials, in order to have an optimized use of all the resources and all the energy systems. On top of that, we increase critical mass of knowledge in order to provide solutions and to come with unexpected ideas. And of course, innovative brains and talent will work together across these regions. You see my contact email address, but also of the executive director of SPIRE. And so you can contact us for further questions. And I'm, of course, open for questions if time still allows it now as well. I thank you very much and look forward to questions and further emails on that.